tell you about a book which I really liked, and it's 14 Reasons Why. It's a book written by J.A. Sher. It was his debut, and now we can watch a series on Netflix. The book tells a story about two people, Hannah Baker and Clay Jensen. Hannah Baker committed suicide, and Clay Jensen was her friend who got a box with several cassette tapes. The cassette tapes were recorded by Hannah, and on the tapes there are information why she committed suicide. One of the reasons of her death is Clay Jensen. For him it's impossible because he just thinks that he didn't do anything. And when he listened to the tapes, he will find out why he's the one of the reasons. As we know, because they're in the title we have 13 reasons why, there are 13 reasons, so they are also 13 cassette tapes. Hannah is talking about many silly things, but silly things for another people that caused her death. For them, it was funny and it wasn't a problem, but actually, for Hannah, it was really painful. I think that this book shows many things that can show us too that people need us sometimes and we don't see that. So it's really important to be good to people because we never know what they are going through. I really like this book and I think that you will like it because it's also for children like for adults. We can also watch the series, as I said before, on Netflix. Why it's good to watch series? I think that it's really important because it can show us a real language and learn and teach many important things and new words. I recommend this book and the series because I think that they are really good. Thanks.
My name is Michalski. Bartek Michalski. I won't talk about James Bond, but about three Polish films that you absolutely must see. I have been interested in film for as long as I can remember. I watch different kinds of films, and all of them are of course great entertainment, but also they teach me a lot about the world, the history, and the present day. The three films that I want to talk about show different aspects of Polish culture and recent history. Do you know which Polish films were the most popular in the last years? The blockbuster of 2014 was a story of a struggle to do something completely impossible of those times in Poland, the first heart transplant. The man who made it happen was legendary Polish surgeon, unconventional, charismatic and determined Zbigniew Religa. The team of doctors, headed by Religa, gave people new life, saving them from death. And that's why the film is called Gods. I was really impressed by a stunning performance of Tomasz Kot in the lead role. I think he's the best Polish actor nowadays. He has played a wide range of roles. He created completely different character in the next year's Disco Polo. I guess that you're not the fans of this kind of music, I'm not anyway, but this is a really good comedy. In a fairy tale convention, it tells a story about super speed career of Disco Polo band, helped by luck, and producer, played by Tomasz Kot. This is because the great actors play and setting the story in the Wild West that I strongly recommend you to see Disco Polo. Tomasz Kot doesn't appear in the third film that I want to talk about, which unlike the previous one, makes you totally depressed. These are paintings of the famous Polish artist, Zdzisław Beksiński. As you can see, they are so depressing. And such is the film about Beksiński, his wife and his son, called The Last Family. You wouldn't recognize the legend of Polish cinema, Andrzej Seweryn, looking exactly like Beksiński and becoming him in this film. I recommend you to see The Last Family in spite of its pessimistic atmosphere. Death, including suicide and murder, is presented in the life of this family from the beginning to the end. They make each other's life a nightmare. The three films that I just recommended are very interesting and different from each other. You find out a lot about important Poles and their private life. You look at Polish high culture and mass culture, which is disco polo music. As you can see, watching films is definitely not wasting time. Now you must excuse me, because I must see a film that is just starting. See you in the cinema.
In 2008, two friends, Mark Merville and Brandon Beck, who are the founders of Riot Games, announced they are going to create a game called League of Legends. They didn't know it is going to become one of the most popular esports games in the world. Over 67 million of people play the game every month, and over 20 million of people every day. The World Championships of third season were the most popular esports event in history. But what is the game about? There are several modes in game. And the classical one, you have to destroy the enemy base to win a match. There is also a ranking system in the game, which motivates players to play better and win more matches and cooperate with teammates. And that's the point where we come to the purpose of the presentation. What are the advantages of playing games? As I said before, you need to cooperate with teammates in multiplayer games. That teaches us that communication is a very important thing in real life if we want to reach our goals. Next advantage of playing games is that we learn English. Most of games aren't translated into English, so we can play in our native language. And we have to manage playing in English. Another advantage is that we can keep in touch with friends. We can use programs like TeamSpeak 3 or Skype to talk, and we can play at the same time. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching.